Hey guys, welcome back to GKCodelabs. This is the next session in our Apache Spark series. In last session, we discussed about sequence files and how we can read and write a sequence file using Apache Spark. So let's move on to Spark documentation and let's see what else we have. There are RDD operations. I think I have already explained this multiple times, the map, reduce and using different functions on the normal text file. So let me skip through this. So next comes is passing functions to Spark. So this is also somewhat important, how we can pass functions to Apache Spark, like how we can define our own function and perform that function on any RDD or data frame by directly passing the function itself to Spark context. So that is what basically what we are going to discuss in this session. So the documentation says we can define our own function in any object or in a class, and using that object reference, we can pass our entire function into any function that we are using along with an RDD or data frame. So here you can see they have some my RDD. And while doing map, they are not writing any custom loose code in the map function. In place of that, they are passing entire function that was part of a my functions object. So let's take a small demo on how we can do that. Maybe it can be helpful in any of your use cases. So I have created a basic boilerplate code. I'm skipping all the unnecessary code build and cropping the videos in middle just for the time concerns. So here we have an object passing function to Spark, and we have created a Spark context using conf. So let me create an RDD. I won't read any files or something, but just to have a RDD, what we can do, a basic thing that was parallelizing a collection. Let me do a data. Let's take an array, and we have 1, 2, 3. Suppose this is our array, and as discussed multiple times, to create a RDD, let's take val parallelized RDD will be sc.parallelize, and it will be data. Fine, no confusion till here. Let's say I want to do some operation in this RDD data, but I have some long functionality and I don't want to do everything inside map and flat map and everything. This becomes long and confusing, or some other reason. So let me write some other function, and that we will pass into this RDD, if you are getting my point. So let's design a simple function. Let's suppose I want all the data to be added by number 2, let's say. So let me define a function def add 2. Now thing here to note is this, we are planning to pass it to a let's say map function. Let me write here, suppose pair RDD dot map, and here in place of writing something like x such that x plus 2, I want to pass a function. So if you are planning to make such function, you have to take care what function you are using. You are using map. How map works? Map works for every data row by row. So in that row, what you are getting? Because all that function that will call will take input of that row type. Because first this map function will run on 1, then on 2, 3, 4, 5, like normal RDD concept. So we have to define a function which takes the input as an argument of type whatever we are expecting for that map. In this case, what our add function has to take, it has to take an integer. Any function scala, when we are expecting some type of input, we have to define it like I and the type of it. It is int. And now what we have to return from this, we after doing a map function, it will again return us an RDD, right? And for returning also, if we are adding 2, again that will give an integer only. Or if you are doing some other multiplication division, you can define your own data type like what you expect. And in this case, after adding also, I am expecting an integer to be returned. Let's write what we want in this function. We have to take whatever argument is coming, that is each element in the pair RDD, and what we have to do is we have to add 2 to that. That's it. And this value we have to return. Fine, right? Simple. Now once our function is defined, we can simply call it on our pair RDD. Pair RDD dot map, and we can directly pass this add 2 function. And you can see here, while returning, we are returning the summed up value with 2 for each and every element. So again, this will also return us an RDD. So val, you can say new RDD is equal to this. So you saw, right, in place of multiple statements, X or Y that implies and all, flat map and multiple things, you can define a big logic inside any of your function. Just make sure of what arguments it is expecting in that function from that you are passing to an RDD and what is the return type. This was a basic example. Now let's see what our new RDD has. New RDD dot collect dot for each. Let println. Let me try to run this passing function to Spark. So here you can see we got the summed up value with 2. 3, 4, 5 to 7. That is 1 to 5, each number added by 2. So that was all for this session. That was how you can make your own function and pass to any transformation that you are performing on any RDD. So if you are able to understand it, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. And stay tuned for coming sessions on Apache Spark.